words with him before we come down onto the ring area tonight.
Very popular, Dick. They love him.
They do love him. And the cheer goes up because here is the Olympic strongman, the former Olympic strongman, and a heck of a wrestling talent, Ken Patera. This place is going to come apart at the seams in just a minute.
Oh, getting a little rough here to throw in some rubber balls.
Well, you get a reaction when this guy comes by.
Yep.
I don't necessarily approve of it, the things they throw here, but anyway. All right, the crowd looking expectantly toward the other side of the... Here we come, here we come. Here comes the crowd, and here comes you-know-who, the number one main man, Bruno. Arnold Skaaland, his manager, preceding him. Here he is. There's the man. Everybody loves him, except Ken Patera.
He lights up the ring when he comes in, doesn't he? Welcome back, Bruno.
He's home.
Yeah.
I don't care if he does come from Pittsburgh. Yeah. He's home.
Yeah, and South Philadelphia loves
him. You bet it. They love him to death.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is set for one fall with a one-hour time limit.
Oh, mercy. 1 hour.
It is for the Intercontinental Championship. Introducing first the manager, the Golden Boy, Arnold Skaaland. In the corner to my left, from Portland, Oregon, 278 pounds, he is the Intercontinental Champion, Ken Patera. And wrestling fans, his opponent, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, 248 pounds, the living legend of professional wrestling, Bruno Sammartino.
Well, they have had some magnificent battles here in the past.
This ought to be a dandy tonight, folks.
Yeah, the anticipation is already rising to a fever pitch.
And so is the temper of Patera. I watched him as Sammartino came into the ring, and he hasn't taken his eyes off him for a second. He's just like staring bullets through him. That's what it's all about, fans. There's the belt. We can get a look at it, being held by Dick Worley. Now he's handing it off. All right, Bruno getting ready. All right, Bruno, hey, man, he's like a horse in the starting gate. He's ready to go. He wants to charge.
Well, in the past, he would have attacked, but he's going to let him take it all off.
Yep.
He's okay. Just keeping warmed up and limber.
Patera usually is very careful and very dainty with the pants getting him off. Tonight, I think he's a little bit nervous. I'm not saying he's scared. I wouldn't imply that, but he's nervous. And here they go. Look out, fans. Hang on to your hat. It's an hour time limit tonight. Bruno, that doesn't bother Bruno.
No. Well, Patera knows his strength, and he's feeling it.
He's slammed
it back. He can't believe it. Can't believe it. Look at Bruno. He's doing the pectoral trip on him.
These guys are always psyching one another, I'll tell you.
Yeah, well.
As if they really had to, but I guess it's all part of it. They got to do it. Now, Sammartino, fans, is the shorter of the two, and that could be in a stand-up battle of strength. There might be some semblance of an edge to Patera. I'm not really sure. You know, both these guys are in fantastic condition tonight. Sammartino told us a year or two back, one night we were talking to him before the matches began. He works out all the time in Pittsburgh, has a gym down the basement of his home. Look at him. There's a battle of strength. Both these guys standing straight up. They got a lot to prove tonight. And Patera, who's strong as can be. Look at him. Look at up. Patera grabs him by the back of the head and for a takedown.
That was an unbelievable battle. He just sat and looked at it. My goodness.
But you know, as great as I, you know, whether you like him or not, again, Patera's a very fine wrestler. But you notice a lot of these guys, they have to go to the illegal tactic.
Yeah.
They can't do it straight up with a guy. Patera's fantastic.
Well, if they let him get away with it, they're going to do it.
I know. Here we go, back to the battle again. Sammartino and Patera. Look at him. Look at the determination on Bruno.
That is amazing. I mean, that's a sight to remember for the rest of your life. Look at that face.
You think a lot's not at stake? Not the belt, man. There's the hair takedown again. Hair pull. Whirly's very sharp with these things, and his hair pulling and choking and all the rest. He's seen it all. He's very quick with this. Well, Patera using the his strength on Bruno's arm and shoulder now, but they're both up, and here we go back to the battle of strength.
Yep. Well, this is important psychologically to set the tone of the match.
Yep.
Of course, Sammartino hasn't been in a ring for some time. Look at the pain on Patera's face.
There goes
the hair again. See, he was defeated. He was getting licked.
Yep.
And what he's telling Bruno is, I can't take you on, man.
Yeah, that's what he's saying. He's telling the fans that, too. They all see it.
And Bruno's got him. He's got the psychological advantage on him.
Now, Patera's doing the hair pull bit.
Well, that's a defeatist attitude when you have to go to that. That's not an advantage. You're not going to beat Bruno Sammartino by pulling his hair.
No way.
Like a girl.
You got to beat him.
Yeah. Look at him. Bruno's saying, hey, come on, fight like a man, not like a little girl.
Well, Dick Whirly lead it out.
Bruno's calling him a sissy. And now he's going to the crowd. Go to Bruno. Hey, Bruno's got contempt for him. Enough of this guy. Come on. Let's go. Look at Bruno. All right. You want to wrestle? Let's go. He's laughing at him. All right. Let's lock. Well, Bruno's too much of a gentleman. Well, that's hard on the ear. Stunned him a little. Hard blow.
Oh, look at Patera. Patera now is incensed. Look.
Yeah.
Series of elbow smashes on.
On that right ear. And Bruno's right ear is cauliflowered.
Yeah. Throws him off.
Yeah. Bruno does have a cauliflower right ear. Spread eagle. He's working those shoulder blades.
Sammartino,
he's going to break him. Look at that, like Superman. Look at him. Look at Bruno. Oh, the power. Look at the power. He didn't get him. You got to give Patera credit. He did do it.
Yeah, he did.
He did do it. He went more. It's terrible pain on Bruno. Look at the sweat pouring from his forehead.
Here he goes again.
Look at that stretch. Look at it. Oh, you almost want to pull with him, don't you, Dick?
I know.
Look at it.
You got to be involved.
Oh, what a man. But Patera's in charge. He's right in the saddle.
That's the second time.
Today, shouting to the crowd, I got you. Come on, Bruno.
Bruno's got something to prove here. He's got to do it. He's going to have to do it.
He's puffing. Look at him. Oh, look at this.
Look, just puffing and puffing. Look.
Unbelievable. What an exhibition here. The crowd is you can feel the whole crowd is like straining.
There's the third time.
Yeah.
Third time.
But Patera's got him. Look at Patera. Look at those biceps.
What did he say?
I didn't catch it.
I got you pretty well bombed, so.
There's a small cut on the forehead of Patera. I don't know where it came from.
Look at that. The trapezes are flexed. The deltoids. Every muscle's in action.
Bruno has got, he won't leave tonight until he breaks that hold.
And look how the thighs are set, both of them. Their legs are planted, just solid like a tree trunk. Look at the crowd clapping. They're getting a few shots. The crowd reaction. Look at the crowd are just into this.
Oh,
he reversed him. Oh, they can't believe it.
Oh, look.
Oh, he ran like a...
He ducked out. He
ran
ducked
like
out
a sissy. Ran like a sissy. Oh. He said, take that. You hear Bruno? Bruno said, take that. Oh, I'm getting limp. Just why? How do you feel, Dick?
Are you kidding?
Oh.
I can't talk.
I wouldn't be want to be anywhere else but right here tonight.
This is a happening, fans. Yeah. A happening. You're watching it tonight.
Break the hold. Step back.
Worley says, break it up. Step back.
Uh-oh.
Nobody stepped
Bruno
anywhere.
Taking a
smack
couple
him.
Of shots
Smacks.
There.
Oh. Oh, and a Labanza. Left hook. Left hook. He's going to unload on him. Oh, a left hook from the floor. He busted his head open. The forehead's busted. Going to break him on the... Oh, he's got him on Weird Street.
He took some shots tonight, folks.
Boy, Bruno is back in form.
He is all right.
He's working on that forehead. He sees it's open.
And
right
another shot.
Yeah, on the forehead, Dick. Yeah,
look at Sammartino's face. He's loving this.
It's target practice.
He's loving it. Uh-oh, rake the eyes.
Well, that isn't going to save him.
It's a desperate man. Oh,
he's
got a body slam.
Yeah, Bruno left himself open.
Body slam. Count of two. Sammartino shoves him away.
He's timing it.
Oh!
Was Bruno ready for him? Was he ready for him?
Shot and a half. Sammartino, listen, he's been around too long, man. He knows.
You got it. He's been around too long. Watch him whip him. No reversal.
Uh-oh.
Oh, did Bruno write the book on brawling
in
the ring?
Yes, he did, man. He did it. Look at it.
Oh.
Patera really gave his arm a shot. His shoulder, look at it. He's,
Bruno's going to finish him right on that shoulder, left shoulder.
Same thing. Watch it now. He, look at it.
What's he
Bruno
got in store
loves
for him?
It. Bruno loves it.
He's going to do him now. He's going to do him on that rope. Oh, goodbye left arm. Goodbye.
He was going to take that home with him tonight.
Yeah.
You got to yank it off.
Yeah, going to serve shoulder steak tonight. Working that left shoulder.
Shot.
Another shot. Another one.
Oh.
Row your boat. Row your boat. Oh, there's no left arm left.
Bruno, look at him. He saved the crowd. What do you want me to do?
What do you want me to do? What do you want? You want the left arm?
How do you want me to put him away? Just
where do you
tell
want
me.
It? They're counting.
He's incredible.
Channing. Five, six, eight.
Dick Worley's right on the scene, and he's indicating to Patera, do you want to submit? He says, no, you got to give him credit.
Yeah, it's like Bruno and Zbyszko.
Yeah. Oh.
He might have taught Zbyszko everything Zbyszko knows, but Bruno did not teach Zbyszko
everything
that Bruno
right.
knows, right? You got that right.
You're a man with the words.
I hope so.
Dick Graham here with Kal Rudman, ringside, along with you folks, whether you're here with us in the Spectrum or you're watching at home, wherever, you're seeing it tonight and loving every second of it. Bruno is just, working on that shoulder and upper arm area. Look at him.
Well, next time that Patera wants to hold up that left bicep, won't be much
he
left.
He won't be able to brush his teeth tonight.
I hear you.
Morning with
I heard that.
All right. Oh, come around the back now. He's going to pull it. Uh-oh. Oh!
Oh,
here, look. He slammed him with his... Yeah. Oh!
With the arm underneath.
The arm underneath.
That I've never seen before.
No. Oh, look. He's trying to break it off of the elbow.
Yeah, well, Bruno could be arrested for what he's doing now.
Well.
It's legalized mayhem.
I know.
You know, he had a bad back anyway, Patera.
Look at him. Second kick in the shoulder.
Right on the tricep.
Third.
Look at it. See that? Right on the triceps. Yeah. He knew exactly where to put the point of the toe.
Look, he's just jamming that shoulder, yeah. Just twisting it, turning it, grinding it.
Can you imagine the pain that Patera's undergoing right now?
I don't feel, I'll tell you, I feel sorry for the man.
Yeah.
I really do.
Yeah, he came in with his wife, I guess. I don't know. I hope she's not watching.
Yeah. Some of these ladies sit up in the press box watching their men, and I'll tell you, they got to go through the same agony.
Well, I don't know how
I'll look, look. Patera's trying to get through it. Look, there he goes. Up his...
He wants to reverse. He doesn't know what to do.
He wants, to slam an arm around, but he...
There's no leverage. There's no room. There's no way. No way.
Bruno can just move with him. He is.
Oh, he got him.
He got him. Oh, there's the second one.
Yeah.
Oh, that's choking. Yeah. That's choking.
And he's holding the rope, too, and he's on the rope. It's illegal. That was a hard blow.
Bruno's down. Yeah. I don't know whether. Here we go with a full Nelson.
Right.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, he broke it like nothing. Broke it like a toothpick. Again on the left arm. Again. Now he's using the rope on it.
Patera is just there. He's outside the ring.
What took him so long? He leaves long before
that. He needs time. Yeah. He's buying a lot of time here.
Oh, it finally caught up to him, that left arm.
Yeah.
Oh, we better get out of the way. He's got his eye on us. And his head split open.
He's still favoring his shoulder now on the upper arm.
You notice I pulled the microphone away. He'd have gone for it, sure.
Bruno right on top of him again. A couple of his knees. Look at it. Going after that shoulder again and again. Outside the ring he goes. Yeah.
Oh, he's in excruciating pain.
You know, he's in such pain, he can't even respond to the needle he's getting from the ringsiders tonight.
You know, if he weren't such a son of a gun, I'd feel sorry for him, wouldn't you?
I know what you mean.
Yeah, you hear me.
Bruno's right back on him again.
No left arm. No, he's trying with one leg, and you can't fight Bruno with one arm.
Look at it.
There was no contest. Got him again with that arm. Look at it. Using the rope. Four shots.
There he goes outside the ring again.
He does not know what to do. He can't even think straight.
There goes Bruno right after him. Look at him. He's got him. Look.
Yeah.
He's got it.
Oh, he's in the metal. He's no mercy. No mercy. He's got
Bruno,
a chair.
Bruno's back inside. Oh, the chair over his back. Right in the small of the back. Does the pair inside after him.
He's pushing Whirly out. He's going to use the chair on him on the back. That's the end of the fight.
That's it. I heard the bell.
Well, he couldn't fight anymore. What's he going to do to him?
Rick Worley's got him in the full Nelson again, but I don't know. He can't have much strength on that shoulder anyway.
No.
He's got Sammartino down, but not out, of course.
Here come the other wrestlers.
He's Tony Garea.
Now he's running now.
Tony Garea in there.
Yeah.
Martel.
Yeah, well, they were afraid he was going to, you know, Bruno's neck. After the injury that he sustained some time ago.
Everybody's on their feet tonight. Yeah. Fans, look out. Sammartino's... Patera came around the other side. I thought he's coming in our direction again. I think he's probably going to get back and get out of the area because I'll tell you.
I hope there's no injury to Bruno's neck or the cervical.
I know. We've got...
Here's Phil Zacco, the promoter. He's very concerned.
Very much so.
Yeah. Yeah, he's injured.
He's not only a wrestler, but they're friends, personal friends.
Yeah, they did something.
There's Martel in there, Arnold Skaaland. You've got Tony Garea.
Yeah.
Marvilla.
Yeah, Marvilla there.
Yeah, he's in there, too.
14 minutes, 57 seconds. Ken Patera has been disqualified. The winner of the match, Bruno Sammartino.
Well, you know, he's sure to be fined by the State Athletic Commission.
Should
be. The use of that chair. Yeah. No question, there should be a hefty fine for that.
Well, they're,
you've got to understand, Dick Graham, they're helping him down.
Yeah,
that,
they are.
In the heat of battle, and Gorilla Monsoon explained that to us, you'll go for a baseball bat, you'll go for a chair. You can't blame a wrestler. I mean, the pain that he was enduring, he was not rational.
Well, the...
Bill? How you doing, buddy?
How you doing? I got you.
So, you've got to justify whatever he had to do, you know, to do that.
The winner of the match remains Bruno Sammartino.
All right, fans, I'll tell you, this place is just beginning to settle down now after all that excitement.
Here's the replay.
All right, let's watch it. Outside the ring now. Now, here's Patera. There's Sammartino trying to get back in. Patera helps him with a chair over the back. Ooh, that hurt.
Yeah, right in the small of the bat.
He throws the chair back in. He gets back in himself. Now, watch. He'll pick the chair up again. Right over the
Whirly
back.
Couldn't
he
stop
pushes
him.
Whirly out of the way. Pushes him aside.
Yeah.
Whirly goes for the bell then.
Oh, right on the back.
Whirly, meanwhile, had gone for the bell. He said, all right, get the bell. Come on, that's all.
He's still holding
Patera,
it, holding his shoulder. Yeah, he was in excruciating pain. Horrible. Not. Oh, I see what he's doing. He's just bending that neck and working on the cervical vertebrae there.
Oh,
I see. That's why the wrestlers had to come in, because he's breaking the neck. I mean, you can imagine the strength that he has and what he's doing there.
All right,
he
fans,
wanted to cripple him.
He certainly did. Yeah. Here come the other guys. All right, you got...
he's fighting like an enraged bull.
Maria there.
Yeah. Then he realized he couldn't take on those three wrestlers.
Well, I'll tell you, fans, just want to mention to you, at the Zimbo Moss, 3rd and Division Street in Harrisburg, on Friday, November 28th at 8:40 p.m., you folks in the Harrisburg area, you want to travel over to the Zimbo Moss, 3rd and Division, to see the feature. It'll be special attraction Moondog number 1, Moondog number 2, both from Georgia, against Manuel Soto and Dominic DeNucci. And then Sergeant Slaughter, Pedro Morales are going at it, an all-star card. Johnny Rodz, Rick Martel, and a bunch of them. Okay, and of course, there's a good reminder that on Saturday, December 13th, here at the Spectrum at 1:30, unusual matinee. Why, on PRISM, you're going to see Spectrum Wrestling. And we don't know yet who will be the attractions, but you can bet one thing, it's going to be a big, big wrestling card.
This will be your fifth match, ladies and gentlemen. This will be your fifth match with a 1-fall, 30-minute time limit. We have in this corner, in the blue red striped trunks, 305 pounds from South Carolina, Sergeant Slaughter. In this corner, he is in red trunks, 230 pounds from Santa Domingo. It is Angel Marvilla. Your referee in the ring at this time, Dusty Bellbomber. 1-fall, 30-minute time limit.
You know, I'll tell you something, Kal Rudman, you almost look like a mismatch here if you're just judging by size alone.
Yeah.
Marvilla is not as well set up. Let's not take anything from him. But Slaughter is just...
70 pounds, Dick.
Yeah, he gave away a lot of weight there.
Well...
But don't let's not feel sorry for Mavia. He knows he's been around a while. You know it's going. Huh? He's starting to battle the words right now.
Mavia's a tough customer. He really is.
Well, they can talk all night, but it's going to be done in the ring. Oh, Slaughter's showing him how he's going to do it, huh?
Well,
it could be Mavia put a lot of speed on him and offset the bulk.
Yeah, Mavia's been in there with everybody, so he's not intimidated. But Slaughter is something else. This is his debut at the Spectrum.
Yeah. This is the first visit of Slaughter, just as we saw the Hangman for the first time last month, and he'll return again tonight. Well, look at the Slaughter, a series of smashes in the face of Marvilla, and he's, he's seeing stars outside the galaxy right here at the Spectrum.
Stars over Alabama.
Yeah, wherever. It's sort of a side headlock, but... this guy Slaughter is not fancy, he's just a punisher.
Well, that Marvilla's shot there to the abdomen didn't even faze him at all.
I thought we were going to see a body slam, but no, he's going to bend him over backwards over the ring turnbuckles and smash him.
That was tough. Just laid him out there like a pancake and smack.
And, break him over the knee. One, two, and Slaughter lets him up because this is not all. He wants to do more to him. And another smash on the... Oh, what a backbreaker. Series of two of them. They're pretty much... there's Marvilla with a leg over the lower rope, so they got to break this.
This is going to be a short match.
Maybe. Marvilla just can't get it together.
Nice.
A little dirty pool there, grabbing the back of the trunk to get a little leverage.
Oh, that hurts.
His kidneys are going to be totally out of shape.
Those are fearsome blows. Fearsome. I don't know how he can take it, Marvilla. He's... Reversal.
Look at that, would you? Marvilla had enough to smash him into the ring ropes in the corner. Slaughter, for the first time, has...
That's about the first time anyone's ever done it.
He was going to wind up and crank down, but Marvilla gave him a shot to the midsection.
Yeah, you don't see drill sergeants get it too often. Marvilla is
working
out on him.
You're seeing some agility here now.
Yeah.
I was going to say, a knee lift actually is a kick. Marvilla giving it back to him, man. I'll tell you, here he comes.
Marvilla's left-handed, and there is power in that left. The crowd can't believe that Slaughter is taking a beating.
Well, there's a side headlock, and now into the ropes.
Won't last long. I knew it. Told you it wouldn't last long.
Well, when you're giving away 70 pounds like that, no way you can do that. No shoulder blocks.
Yeah, and Slaughter's a winner. He's not a loser.
Dropped him.
That is brutal. Oh, no.
Only by sheer luck he didn't come down on top of his head.
All 300 pounds on that knee. This is it. That's it. That does it. The clothesline.
Well, he's got him now,
I think.
Got him unless
now.
Unless he chooses not to.
He's...
Now look at your monitor.
Yeah, this is it.
Look at him. He just...
The claw.
How'd you like to be a recruit and have him as your drill instructor on Paris Island?
Well, they were recruits, and he had them.
He's
ruining him now. They should stop it immediately.
I wonder if he's going to be any good. Oh, Marvilla.
He's going to really hurt him now. That's a horrible hold. But legal.
Yeah, legal.
I think he's ready
no
to call
choke,
over.
Yeah, no choke, because you can see neck area.
He's finished. There's no point in this now.
He's bending the vertebrae, everything.
That's it. That's it. There's nothing left. No, he don't want to stop now.
Count of two, count of three, and he broke it. Okay.
Well, that's sad. I hate to see that, Dick.
Well.
Yeah, you're proud of yourself. Okay. He likes it. Yeah. What'd he say? Did I do good? Yeah, how'd I do? Welcome to the Spectrum in Philadelphia.
The time of the submission, 4:06. The winner, Sergeant Slaughter.
Well, fans, you saw the debut, if you will, of Sergeant Slaughter, who incredibly has extended his hand to Marvilla.
Well, you know why? Because he gave him a fight, and he respects him. He really does. He respects him, or he wants to beat him up.
Well, maybe. I
don't
know.
See what he does now.
Oh,
no.
I told you.
This is terrible.
Come on.
Gotta get some of the wrestlers in and break this before he sends them to the hospital. Oh, that isn't right. He's just a mean man. He's mean.
That's all.
Oh, he's mean.
And Barbilla's favoring the back of his neck now.
There was no cause for that. The crowd is stirred up. They hate him. He is a rotten.
Oh, look at it. He can't even.
Now, the referee had to break that. He's in
he's
horrible
in terrible
pain.
Terrible pain.
They're getting
Willie,
the camera
I don't know
over
he's going to make it again. Look at it.
He really did something to him. Now, there was no reason for that.
No, he had him. He had him. He had him from the time they stepped on the ring.
Yeah, poor unsuspecting guy. He went and he shook hands.
That
he should have never got up and shaken hands with him. I don't believe what I saw.
All right, let's check your screens, fans, and we'll show you the instant replay. Here we go. Into the ring ropes. Little leverage there. And now, zap. Yeah, look at him. He just almost took that head off. All right, now watch him. He's getting up. Look at him smacking his fans like he's dusting them off. Ring doctor, by the way, the ring doctor is over to our right checking Marvilla. Marvilla is just,
He's in bad shape.
He is in bad shape.
No, that should have never happened.
He's doctor checked him out. I guess he'd allowed him to go back to the dressing room, but murder. All right, here we come. Look, here we go. Look at the hole. Look at the punishment. Look at it. Look. And here, just a second or two, will be Dusty Feldbomber just saying, hey, that's enough. That's enough. Look at him, just shaking him. There it is. Just look, he's just about unconscious now. Well, fans, here we go. The crowd coming alive because here he is, Peck's bad boy himself from Pittsburgh, and it's Larry Zbyszko versus Bob Backlund, the champion and the guest referee tonight. Check this, if you will. The magnificent Tony Atlas. I'll tell you, we haven't seen Backlund yet. The crowd's going to come apart the seams here at the Spectrum when he comes in. Backlund, of course, has been up against this guy before, and Zbyszko won't rest till he's finally declared the new living legend, which is not accepted by anybody. Well, only Larry Zbyszko.
Well, the last time, Zbyszko ran like a thief. I want to say one more thing about Sergeant Slaughter. He's going to get his. If you think that the other wrestlers aren't aware,
well,
you know, making a guy's got to make a living, and defeating a guy is one thing, Dick Graham, but...
Well, Cal, what goes around comes around. Larry Zbyszko for president.
Well,
Frank even sent us, our director, picked that up, one of the signs around here, and a lot of them. That was in the upper deck up there, and there's some other... Actually, there are a lot of Zbyszko fans here tonight, believe it or not. And the crowd's starting to come alive here. They're giving it to Zbyszko. And he's just pacing back and forth, waiting for the arrival of the champion himself. And I think we've got something going. Yes, it is Bob Backlund. Here's Tony Atlas. Look at the size of this guy. Look at him. He's a hero tonight, I'll tell you. Look, they love him here. They love him. Tony Atlas.
Tony, said hello to us.
Yep.
Now, if I was going to the bad side of town...
Here's another guy went with.
Well, all I want him to do is be with me. He doesn't have to do anything.
Right.
Take one look at him.
Well, he wouldn't have to do anything. Just show up. Look at that. Look at the muscle. Look at that.
You know what Tony's like? You cross a parrot with a tiger. I don't know what you got, but when it talks, you better listen.
All right, here's Bob Backlund coming in the ring area.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It is set for one fall to a finish. It is set for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first our special guest referee, Mr. USA, Tony Atlas.
Tony is now telling the rules, according to Atlas, to Zbyszko.
Ladies and gentlemen, the challenger
and,
to my right.
He smacked
from
Atlas
Pittsburgh,
on the chest.
Pennsylvania, 231 pounds, Larry Zbyszko.
Little conference there with Tony Atlas and Bob Backlund.
And wrestling fans, his opponent this evening, from Princeton, Minnesota, 234 pounds. He is the current World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, Bob Backlund.
Well, you know something? I think Zbyszko is going to talk Tony Atlas's head off. He's bending Atlas's ear like crazy over there.
Yeah.
Don't worry. Look at that guy. He comes from about 8 feet wide in the shoulders down about 2 inches wide at the waist. Look at the build on him. There's what it's all about. There's our alert ringsider catching up to the belt, and that's the name of the game. With it goes all the glory, the money, the prestige, and that's what Bob Backlund has, and that's what Zbyszko would like.
Oh, look at this.
Boy,
don't mess with Atlas.
No.
Look, Atlas found him with something. Atlas ain't playing with him. He got it. Atlas got it.
Woo-hoo!
He got it. He got it. And there goes Backlund. Murder. He's going to whip him. Oh, this match is out of sight, our way.
Oh. He's giving it to him now, fans. Look
Pile
out.
Driver.
Woo!
Boy, Backlund is not playing with him. Zbyszko looks beat already. That's amazing how he found that foreign object. Now he was ready for that one.
Well, we've seen this before.
Yep. It was the whole bottom of the foot, full force in the face. That was a hard blow.
Yeah.
All right. Tony says wrestle.
All right. There it is.
Yeah. Zbyszko stunned.
Zbyszko just hang on the ropes.
Rake. Counter punch with a left hook right
the
out.
Ring.
Yeah, he threw her right and there was a left hook counter.
Him. Oh, look out.
Our way. Here he comes.
Oh,
oh, full force his head. Did you see that? His forehead just bounced off our table, Dick.
He came at us like a shot tonight.
Yeah, I hear you.
Came at us like a shot. Zbyszko outside the ring being counted now by...
Well, there's no mistaking the count with the whole crowd doing it. Boy, this is as much action as anybody ever expected. On the attack, Bob Backlund.
All right, there you go. Look out.
Oh, Bob is just too
Backlund
fast
down.
For him. He's punishing him.
And then Zbyszko down. Backlund on him like a tiger.
Goodbye, left arm. Goodbye.
All right, there's Backlund giving me a series of shots.
Yeah. He's doing the same thing Bruno did. Just eliminating that left arm from the match.
Yep.
Tony says, do you give up? Do you give up?
Well, he's right on top of the action, and no way he's going to give up.
Yeah.
All right. Backlund very much in control now and yanking Zbyszko around by the one arm, twisting it.
Well, that's what Bob said.
Mauling him.
He just doesn't want to just beat him. He wants to put him into some pain.
Well, look. You talk about trouble. Zbyszko's got it right now. He's got a peck of trouble. Backlund still maintaining superiority during this match so far. The crowd, there's Atlas right on the scene saying, do you give up? Do you give up? I must say, Zbyszko says, I won't. Upper arm of, I'm looking, checking the upper arm of Atlas. His upper arm is like my thigh. This guy's incredible. Backlund applying all kinds of pressure tonight. He's going to rip that arm off maybe before the end of the night.
Well, you can't fault that strategy. You can't fight in this ring with one arm.
No, you cannot. But I must say, Zbyszko's not out of this yet. No. So don't count him out.
No fist. No fist. Boy, Atlas is on the scene.
All right, Backlund. Backlund giving him shot after shot. Back on that arm pressure again now.
Well, the crowd's in an uproar.
They really are. Well, they've seen this come close before, and they want to see Backlund really put Zbyszko away. There are a few, as I said earlier, Zbyszko fans in the audience tonight, but I must say not a lot of them. All right, the pressure still applied by Zbyszko. The crowd kind of hushed right now. Zbyszko quickly gets on his feet.
right.
That's
hey,
amazing.
This guy.
Oh, look at this whip.
How many times have we seen that before? Zbyszko in terrible pain where he is, and of course where the champion is. He smashed his shoulder right into the ring.
Yeah, this is a
post.
Yeah, this is a turning point in the match. He just set.
Oh, a crashing knee to the back of Bob Backlund by Zbyszko.
When Zbyszko hits him with the right knee, he pounds his left foot into the ring to give it greater
power. Zbyszko seemingly in control now. He's waving to Backlund to come on. I want to give you some more. He's giving Backlund a bunch of shots there to the head. Backlund still favoring that upper shoulder, though. Flying knee, and there's a kick to the face of one, two. Whoops.
All right, Backlund put his head into Zbyszko's abdomen. Zbyszko fires back with right hands. Backlund is badly stunned. Powerful smash now for Backlund's back.
Well, for the time being, Backlund is still not doing very well, but he's still in it, still trying to get to his feet. And I must say, to his credit, Zbyszko's given it to him. But, you know, Zbyszko just, he's going to talk his head off. I mean,
that was a hard.
That's what I was
going
to say. Zbyszko starts punishing, then he gets off the on a tangent, starts talking, and then drives Backlund's head into the ring.
He says, come on, Bob. Come on, Bob. Zbyszko is tough. I mean, he is tough.
Yeah. He's giving it to Backlund, but Tony Atlas right on the scene trying to check to see if
what'd he say? What?
I don't know. It didn't look like it was very nice.
He's choking. He's choking. That's what it is. Atlas is going to break the
I think
soul.
That's what it's all about.
Oh, sure.
But I'll tell you, Atlas is right on the scene checking it out. Look at that. Look at that. Look at the arms. All right, he's trying to check to make sure there's no choking going on, but
Backlund,
I think he's very,
breathe.
Very suspicious.
Yeah, Backlund can't breathe. He's quivering.
All right, he's giving
him
trouble.
Yeah,
I mean,
he said you got the man in a choke.
Adam was very careful about that choking, you know.
That's it.
All right, what's it, Brooke? And there's a count of two. All right, got up. All right. Adam says, don't you ever bump me, boy.
Oh, he does have an attitude, doesn't
he? Though?
Oh, he's got an attitude so bad.
There he goes back
choking,
to the choking
right
again.
Back to it. Don't you have a feeling of deja vu that Atlas and Zbyszko have an appointment in
Samara? Maybe they do. Maybe
there
so.
There is a destiny there, Dick.
Could be.
I see it right there. He called him boy, didn't he, huh?
He did.
I heard that. Atlas does not get mad. He gets even. Atlas does not get mad.
He gets even.
He gets even.
Zbyszko almost willing that the champion be out of it. He's punishing like crazy. Backlund's trying to get it going. Here he comes. Trying to get up. Trying to now down again. Fans are clapping and chanting. They're trying to give their strength to the Backlund to get him back up again, get him more in command. Zbyszko, it's all his way right now. Some of the ringsiders trying to help Tony Atlas referee tonight. He'll do his own job. No thanks.
Atlas keeps saying, I catch you choking, man. I catch you choking. You go back to your dressing room.
Backlund's trying desperately to get up again. Down again he goes.
There he is. He's counting. Look at this. I knew it was going to happen. It had to be. Watch this. That's the end of it.
Oh! Woo-hoo-hoo! Look out. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, that was explosive.
5, 6, 7, 8. It looks like a pin. 1, 2. Uh-oh. Well,
boy, there is an instinct when they hear that number 2.
Yeah.
They could be unconscious.
That's
and
right.
They get that
they'll feel
up.
It somewhere. Here we go back to the choke again, maybe.
Yeah, it's a choke.
Yeah,
look.
It's a choke, very yeah. definitely.
Yeah, it's away from Atlas's vision.
And the ringsiders are yelling at Tony Atlas, it's a choke, it's a choke. And now he sees it, I think. Yeah, he sees it.
He said, how many times I got to tell you?
All right, Backlund getting it from somewhere.
He's firing.
He's giving a bunch of shots.
Firing. Like a 16-inch cannon on a battleship. Oh, wow.
Backlund's alive and well. He's all right, folks. He's coming back.
Oh,
he's caught him again.
Low blow. Oh.
Same old stuff.
There we go again.
Zbyszko gets in trouble and goes for the crotch.
Boy, Arnold looks very concerned about that.
Backlund down on the turf. He's down on the floor here at the Spectrum tonight, fans. All right, there we got a shot of Backlund. Yep. By a ringside camera.
Here he goes after
him. He's going to go get him.
He's going to hit our table.
Oh!
Boy. I'm glad he missed the TV monitor.
Yeah, you bet. Backlund, look at him. Just about out of it. Yeah. Backlund is almost totally
Backlund.
Down and now is down.
Yeah. Bob is just can barely move.
He's trying to get up. Backlund's trying to get it
table.
Together.
Yeah.
The champions... tried desperately to get up. There's a countdown over it by Tony.
Here comes after him again. Right off the ring.
Oh,
he's
going to
choke him with the
him.
Microphone cord. Tony's got to get out there and stop him. He's got to. He's holding him with his
he's
right arm.
He's telling him, boy.
Yeah.
He's telling him.
Is he going to go after Tony? Yeah, it looks like he is. He's about a second away from attacking Tony.
You're messing with the wrong guy.
Yeah, he looks like he wants Tony. He wants Tony.
Tony's ready for him.
Yeah, he wants him. But if he hits him one more time, Tony's going to unload on him.
Oh! Backlund was ready and gives him a headbutt. Boy, this thing's seesawing back and forth. There's a smash to the face. Backlund on top of him and into the turnbuckle. Woo-hoo!
Here he comes our way. Oh.
I thought he was gone in your lap that time, baby.
I hear you. He's working. He's working.
Taking
the
best
squad now.
Oh, here
we go. The pile driver. This is it. Perfectly timed. Here it comes. Oh. Now that doesn't do it.
Backlund,
nothing will.
Backlund nailed him good on that one. He nailed him great. Woo.
I don't know how much brains Zbyszko has. He wants to take on Tony Atlas and Bob Backlund in the same ring and the same night, same time.
I suddenly discovered what Zbyszko was using on Backlund. That cord was our TV monitor, AC cord.
Oh. We lost
All right, there's a count of one because the foot of Zbyszko is lying over the third ring rope. Here we go. Oh, over the shoulder and crashing down. And on top of him, I don't know if we got a pin at this point. There's two. Zbyszko pulls out of it, at least for the time being. Oh, he's going to take him for a ride tonight,
The atomic knee drop.
Oh, he's setting him up. Look.
Oh, he's...
He might be sure everybody sees this.
Brutal. Oh, they can pick Zbyszko up with a blotter now.
Well, I think Backlund, once he's back in the ring again, where the devil, where is Zbyszko getting his strength? I don't know, fans.
Desperation. You know, it's really going to take Tony Atlas to handle this situation.
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's calling it.
That's it.
Because he's trying
there
to choke
him. There goes the bell.
In.
There it is.
Now Tony's going to unload on Zbyszko. I know it. You know, even Tony can't break that hold. Zbyszko's homicidal.
Oh! it. That's it. That's it. Fans, that's it, whether you like it or not. Tony Atlas said, oh! Backlund's declared the winner.
Backlund wants to kill him. Gave him that foot twice, right in the puss. Oh, he choked him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the match, 14 minutes, 47 seconds. The winner and still World Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund.
All right, that's what it's all about. There's the belt. Zbyszko back in the ring again.
Yeah.
Oh!
Oh, he attacked Tony, I told you. Oh, and here comes Bob after him. Now he's running like a thief.
Dirty pool, fans. Dirty pool.
Dirty motions also. He injured Tony.
Yes, he did.
Yeah, he really hurt him. He's straightening him out.
Backlund's trying to, trying to get him back with us again.
Go ahead. Oh, Tony was really injured. He caught his neck. Right.
Well, I don't know how many more fans Zbyszko can afford to lose, but he must have lost a few more tonight, fans. Atlas just in bad shape.
Yeah.
Unexpectedly. He was relaxed, not expecting that.
Yeah, right in the cervical vertebra there. That's a bad spot.
All right.
Yeah, he'll be all right.
Tony Atlas coming out of the road.
Oh, no, he's hurt.
He's hurting.
Well, the doctor's over there.
He is hurting.
Yeah.
The doctor at ringside here, he's going to go off with him and check him out.
Zbyszko is over his head now.
December the 13th, 1:45 in the afternoon. We are going to an intermission. Tickets are now on sale for that card at the end of the Spectrum on the floor box office. We shall return after a short intermission. Thank you.
All right, Zbyszko's got him now. He won't let go. All right, Tony Atlas is trying to break him up now.
All right, well,
that's about it. The Well, fans, there you saw it. The windup of the first portion of our wrestling tonight from the Spectrum Live, and we'll make a few mechanical corrections here. Be back with you very shortly. We're going to show you a film feature coming up on PRISM. We have a PRISM feature, and then we'll be back with a special Tony Garea interview with Kal Rudman and myself.
Hello, I'm Jack Williams, president of PRISM. We get lots of mail from our subscribers, and we make an effort to answer each and every one of them individually. However, a lot of the questions are the same, so we thought it might be a good idea to take some time from time to time on the air to answer some of your most frequently asked questions. Here's a letter from Atlantic City dealing with the sports question. It says, Dear Sir, I've been a PRISM subscriber ever since it was available here in Atlantic City, and I have a couple of questions. Number one, why can't PRISM show all the Sixers and Flyers games that are played in the Spectrum during the season? Well, the answer to that is that we schedule 25 Flyers games and 25 Sixers games at the start of each year. And last year, I believe, we showed 27 or 28 Flyers games and about the same number of Sixers games during the regular season. And, of course, we do the playoff games also. We change the schedule from time to time. If we have a big game coming up, we do add it to the schedule. We try to get a proper mix of sports and movies and other entertainment specials so that PRISM can bring you the best rounded entertainment package that is available. But we do show additional games from time to time, and we'll continue to do that. Another question comes from one of our viewers asking about R-rated movies. In fact, it even goes so far to ask about X-rated movies. It says, why doesn't PRISM show R-rated movies in the afternoon, and why doesn't PRISM show X-rated movies later in the evening? Well, we at PRISM schedule our programming for prime time as well as fringe time and in the afternoons. Our matinee movie that runs at 1 o'clock in the afternoon is usually a movie that is rated G or PG. However, we will show some R-rated movies from time to time, I believe beginning in October, at the 1 o'clock slot in the afternoon. It is a discretionary viewing time, and the mothers at home should make a decision whether or not it is a movie they want their children to see. It will be selected movies, because some of the better movies that are presented by the movie companies these days are rated R, not because of nudity or violence or that type of a thing, but one little thing in a movie can cause it to get an R rating. So we will show some R-rated movies selectively only at 1 o'clock in the afternoon as well as at other prime times such as after 8 o'clock in the evening. We don't show R-rated product, for example, at 5:30 when the children would be most frequently watching the television set. As far as X-rated movies, we at PRISM do not show X-rated movies. It is not our policy now, nor it will be in the future. That is something that we don't feel that we're all about. We're an entertainment channel, a family channel, and yes, we show G, PG, and R-rated product to mix in with our exciting sports events, but we just don't think X-rated product has a place on PRISM.
Year's Stanley Cup playoff combatants, the Philadelphia Flyers and the Minnesota North Stars, will renew their rivalry here on PRISM Thursday night, November the 20th. Former Flyer Al McAdam leads the town of North Stars against his old mates. Don't miss it. Face-off time, 8 p.m.
In Philadelphia, and PRISM brings you the unique song stylings of two of Philadelphia's favorite sons, Paul and Oates, in concert.
Do what you want, girl. Be what you are. Now, ain't no right or wrong way. Just a play from the heart.
The Hall & Oates Concert Special, this month only on PRISM.
Wrestling fans, at intermission tonight, a very special guest because it's a very special occasion. Between Kal Rudman and myself is Tony Garea, who's no stranger to the Spectrum or the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, but tonight he's going for the championship belt, and that, I mean, is the tag team. Tony, you must be excited.
Definitely. This is an opportunity that I've waited for quite a few months now. I've got a very, very good partner in Rick Martel, and I feel that now is the time now that we are at our peak as a team. As you know, I wasn't scheduled to wrestle in a tag team match. I was scheduled to wrestle Sergeant Slaughter, but Rick and I talked it over, and we said that we've got to get a match with the Samoans just as soon as possible. And we talked to the promoter here, and I managed to waive this match with Slaughter and get a shot at the title. So tonight's the night.
It's going to be good having that belt around your waist, because I know that's what you expected.
Yes, I've had it around there three times before, and I'm going to make it a fourth time. And I feel that Martel, he's young, but he's very well experienced. He's traveled around the world. He's been in my home country, New Zealand wrestling. He's been in Australia, Asia, Japan, Europe, Canada, and all through the United States. And he's young, but he's very, very experienced. And I'm very happy to have him as my partner. And I believe that we are going to do really well as a tag team combination.
Good.
Well, I know that the Samoans are loaded for bear. They don't want to give that belt up. And they are back alley fighters. I really personally think that Delaware Valley is in for a tremendous treat tonight as far as action is concerned. I anticipate a bloody crush 'em, kill 'em, smack 'em down match. Are my expectations too high, Tony Garea?
They might be just a little bit high, but I'm going to tell you something there. Those Samoans, they're over 300 pounds apiece, where Rick and I are around the 235, 240 mark, so they outweigh us by quite a few pounds. But there's no way that a big man can stay with the pace that we intend to set out there. So our strategy is to wear them down, to razzle and dazzle them, move behind them, over them, anywhere we can. Rick and I, we have very similar styles. We both fly. Rick flies a little bit more than me because I'm a little bit older than him now. I used to do that. I used to do that a few years back, but I slowed down a little bit. But that's going to be our strategy, and I feel that is going to work. I mean, 300 pounds is a lot of weight for anybody to carry around, and they're not going to be able to stick with us. We're very confident about that.
Martel has come a long way, hasn't he, in terms of ability? He seems to get better every month.
Definitely.
There's an escalation in his ability, Tony.
Definitely. This will be the first time that he's held a world championship tag belt, and he's very excited about it. I believe that in the future, Rick Martel could well become a world champion on his own.
Well, you know, Tony, I was thinking as you were talking here a few minutes ago, we've watched the Samoans numerous times, singly and also wrestling with their belt as tag team partners. And you know, sometimes you can get these guys confused by, as you said, fast moves, slick moves, using a lot of speed and dexterity.
Yes, this is right, and this is absolutely what we plan to do. We'll tie them down. For big men, they are in good shape and they do move well, but they're not going to be able to move as much as Rick and I.
Stamina, isn't it? You're counting on your stamina and endurance.
Definitely.
Over the long haul.
That's right. I think if we go in there and we try and take them fast, tables could reverse. So we'll take our time. We'll let them come to us. We'll be very defensive in there. And when the time is right, we'll start moving and he watch us move.
I've got to ask you a question tonight because I know the fans out there, Tony, probably would never forgive me if I didn't ask it. What about your former tag team partner and former friend, I guess you'd say, because you were very close at one time? I mean, of course, your former tag team partner, Larry Zbyszko. What do you have to say about that? He's turned bad. He's turned against everybody. He wants to be called the living legend, the new living legend, rather than Bruno. What do you have to say about that?
Well, I don't have a lot to say about Zbyszko. I've wrestled him in Madison Square Garden twice. I beat the pants off him twice. He knows who's the better wrestler. He knows who kept the tag team together, and he knows how we won the belts when we were tag team champions. It's just that he likes to have the glory and to be in the limelight, and one of these days he's going to be back down, come back down to earth, and he's going to realize what he's done.
Well, I revealed exclusively over the air that his dad, and I don't like to get the family into it, but you have to know about the root that gave you the flower. And his dad, vice president of the United States Steel, and there's a thing about spoiled little rotten rich kids that does
right.
Go to their head.
That's
he
right.
Was raised with a silver spoon in his mouth,
mm-hmm.
and that never went away. That
absolutely
attitude,
right.
We call it attitude.
That's absolutely yeah. right. He got his college education, yeah. and he got his brand new car when he was yeah. 16.
Right.
When I was 16, I was working for, I'm not lying, I was working for just under $10 a 40-hour week.
Yeah.
And I had to save to buy my first car.
That's right. In New Zealand,
the
and
used
England,
car.
That's the way it is.
That's the way it
the
is.
Way it is.
So I know what it's like to go out there and earn everything that you've got, not be given to, and like, oh, that's what he is, he's a spoiled brat. I don't know how I got involved with him in the first place.
Well, he was a different type individual, at least seemingly so at that time, and you know, you got taken in as a lot of people did, so with nothing against your attitude, you thought here was a guy you could really run with for a long time. Well, that's about all the time we have for our intermission interview tonight with Tony Garea. Of course, naturally, we wish him only the very best. I'm not going to wish him luck because he doesn't need that. He makes his own luck by way of the way he wrestles. Cal, any parting comments?
Well, just somebody once described to me that has wrestled Tony, and when Tony hits you with a left hook, or the wrestling form of it, and said that when Tony hits you with a left hook, it travels about 6 inches, and they can count to 100 over your butt in fractions, and you won't get up. And that when he hits you in the gut, it's like a white, hot steel poker. They stuck it in, and left it there. Is that true?
I got a pretty good sized fist there, and I got plenty of knuckle on the end of this. So
I'll tell you one thing. Listen, if you ever want to get out of wrestling, if you need an agent, if you want to go into the movies, I'm your man. Look at that face you got. Look at it, huh? The women love him. And so do the wrestling fans everywhere. That's our interview tonight. We're looking forward to the resumption of our action in just a few minutes.
Continue.
Why don't you stand up and fight this guy hard like you've done before? That was beautiful.
Last time I took the fight too lightly and this man was just plain lucky.
This guy doesn't want to win. He wants to bury you. He wants to humiliate you. He wants to prove to the whole world that it was nothing but some kind of a freak the first time out.
The rematch we've all been waiting for. Sylvester Stallone, Talia Shire, and Burt Young star in Rocky II this month on PRISM.
The Prince of Midair is planning to soar in Philadelphia. That would be the ever-exciting Lloyd Free, who'll be joining his new Golden State Warriors teammates when they do battle with the 76ers on Wednesday night, November the 19th. Follow the flight of both the players and the basketball, exclusively on PRISM.
Eastwood is back as Dirty Harry, the toughest cop in San Francisco.
Do you expect me to believe that a traffic cop is killing off all the top criminals in the city? Huh?
That's right.
Are you out of your mind?
It's incredible as it seems, there may be a whole sub-organization within the police force. Sort of a death squad.
Eastwood and Hal Holbrook star in Magnum Force this month on PRISM.
Sports nostalgia buffs can watch some of the greatest names in pro football history do their stuff on Countdown to Glory, another PRISM Sports exclusive. I'm your host, Jim Barniak, who, along with former Eagles great Tommy McDonald, we'll relive some of the greatest NFL championship games of the fabulous 50s. Join us for Countdown to Glory, Friday nights and Sunday mornings, right here on PRISM.
All right, well, fans, back here at the Spectrum on a Saturday night. There's a good shot of the crowd as they're getting ready to come on back in the to the area where their seats are located, getting ready to resume our action because we're still into the last few seconds of intermission. Cal?
The score of the Flyers game, by the way, the Flyers won 5-4 over the Whalers. Up
all
there in
the Whalers, right? All right.
Okay.
Well, that's we're good news.
Yeah.
And check this, fans. Since October 18th in Philadelphia, live and well in the sports world, check it. Phillies went all the way. 2-0. Eagles 3-0. Flyers 8-0. Sixers 8-0. A total of 21-0 against 21-0-2. I didn't count the Flyers 8-0-2, huh?
Not bad. Well, we're looking forward now to that tag team match, Dick Graham.
Yeah.
And I think the blood is going to flow like claret.
I wouldn't be surprised tonight. Yeah. I think it's going to be a dandy. I wouldn't go too far away from your screen at home, fans. I know the fans in here are just really looking forward to this with great expectation.
What do you think the chances are for the tag team title to change hands tonight, Dick?
Could be. I wouldn't be surprised. And I tell you, you know, you saw the Tony Garea interview at the intermission. The fans were watching. And to that question, I would only say it has a great possibility.
Well, Pedro Morales just arrived in the ring. Going to square off against the Hangman. This should be one heck of a match. Two tough professionals.
All right. Cal, you want to hand me the earpiece to the table mic? I'm having a little trouble here. I'll go with the table mic the rest of the way. Okay.
Yeah, well, when he pulled that cord, when Larry Zbyszko pulled that cord to choke our man there, everything went. Sure worked on Backlund. There sure is bad blood between Tony Atlas now and Larry Zbyszko. I would say there's bad blood between Larry Zbyszko and the immediate world.
Well, that's for sure. Well, we'll pick up the rest of our audio now on the table, Mike, so let's get on with it. Gary, that's Frankie Talent to make the introduction to our next match as we get back from our intermission time. Fans, you heard the introduction. The Hangman's back the second time in 2 months. And bad news, look at him. He's staring at Morales like he doesn't dig him. Wants to put him away as soon as possible, and perhaps that will be what happens tonight. Anyway, there's the Hangman giving Dusty Feldbarmer, the third man in the square and circle, a little bit of trouble. For a fast start tonight.
Yeah.
These guys aren't wasting any time at all.
Well, Pedro has a short fuse, and he's left-handed, and he's got the right guy to ignite that short fuse tonight.
Well, the Hangman has a side headlock on him. It's up to Morales now to try to break it.
Yeah, he's going from the foot.
We've seen him do this before. Oh, look at it.
What power.
He brought the knee and lower leg area on down over his knee. Does he have the Hangman's attention or doesn't he, huh? Boy, oh boy, oh boy, does he have his attention. The Hangman gets no sympathy from the ringsiders here, I tell you that, fans. No sympathy at all.
Well,
Morales really came on.
Pedro's dream is certainly to become heavyweight champion again.
Well, only time will tell whether or not we see that eventuality.
Yeah.
Ringsiders giving some trouble to the Hangman. Hangman wants to converse with him, and they overpowered him. Okay, there's Morales on the top ring. Oh, scratching the eyes, and he says, "Don't mess with me." Morales says, "Don't mess with me." There's a headlock, and Morales is contemplating some evil here. I don't know what. Oh.
Yeah, he just wanted to extricate himself from all of that mess and neutralize the Hangman while he got away.
The Hangman grunts a lot, but
He is a noisy one.
Yeah. Probably noisy eating soup.
Yeah. I think he's from France.
He is indeed. We established that a few months ago, I think.
Oh, like a sack of potatoes.
Oh, slamming him down there. The middle of the back really catches it on that one.
290 pounds.
That's right.
Threw him like an eggshell.
Pedro, of course, wearing the colors of Puerto Rico tonight. And now they got a break if they're on the rope. And the hangman breaks it with a shot. However, Morales says, hey, you want to mess with me?
Yeah, he just missed his nose. He would have broken if he'd have hit him with that left. Look at the musculature on Pedro Morales. Look
I
at
know.
That left arm.
You're really right, Kal Rudman. Yeah. And the hangman's, he's trying to play to the crowd. I think you better forget about it because they don't like him at all, obviously. All right. I thought
that was beautiful.
The hangman was measuring him for a shot to the chops.
He read his mind.
Morales, nobody's fool.
Now he's going to break that left shoulder. It's been worked the left shoulder tonight. Oh.
A little bit of fear in the eyes of the Frenchman, the hangman. He says, I got to get out of here. Don't forget, fans, Saturday, December 13th at 1:45 p.m. will be the next wrestling here at the Spectrum. Saturday, December 13th, 1:45 p.m., if you missed that announcement earlier tonight. One of the unusual Saturday matinee wrestling events at the Spectrum. Okay, the hangman turning things around here against Pedro Morales and applying a great deal of pressure to the arm and shoulder area. Yeah! Looks to me he won't be playing to the crowd at this point in time.
No.
Got things going his own way, at least for the time being. Dusty Feldbaumer checking to make sure everything's okay. One of our camera guys, a longtime buddy of mine, Ralph Hicks, tonight up in our manning one of the cameras up in the press box. His young and not very small son, Paul. He's about 6 feet four. Little on the thin side, but he's young yet. He's a nice boy, and Paul Hicks, Ralph's son, is here learning the ropes, and hopefully he'll be as good a cameraman as his dad, Ralph. We welcome him here tonight, a member of our TV crew. Hangman still applying that pressure on the arm of Pedro Morales. Morales trying to get up, trying to block that pain out of his head. Then there's a hair pull, and down goes Morales again, fans.
Well, if he,
warns him against that hair pull.
Sure. Well, if he can neutralize that left arm of Morales, he will have diminished 80% of his effectiveness because that's where Morales socks you with that left. And Morales is in great pain.
He is indeed. Yeah. And here comes. Brings that lower body from out of space and brings the knee down on the shoulder of Morales.
That was a heavy blow.
And that's the hangman's nothing fancy. Just a brute of a man. Just likes to punish. He's like a lot of wrestlers we've seen from time to time here at the Spectrum. But he's not fancy, but he knows how to hurt you. And that gives him great pleasure. Morales has got
there he goes.
No, there's the hair pull again. Same old stuff.
No.
Dusty Feldbaumer caught that act, and he's warning him, stay away from the hair pull.
Morales is a bomb waiting to explode. This is the lull before the storm.
Well, we've seen him lying there like a cat in the tall grass ready to pounce before. When he gets upset, man, when he gets his Spanish up, look out.
You can imagine the pain on that shoulder. Look at it. Did you ever get the punches for your birthday when you were a kid?
Yeah.
Can you imagine what it is getting hit like that by a 290-pound brute? He is working that shoulder. The shoulder is reddening. You can see it.
Yeah.
They're full force smashes.
Look at him just mauling Pedro Morales.
Right in the axilla. All the doctors know about that. It's a rough spot.
Morales trying to get it going again, but there's right into the ring.
It's amazing. This is the third match in which they've worked on the whole shoulder cage. Seems and very effectively. It's worked, Dick, in every match. Yeah.
Very effectively, Cal. Well, they get you a weak spot, like in pro football, baseball, or baskets, or anything else. So they find the weak spot, they'll work on it. Same thing here in wrestling and boxing. You get a man down, keep him down.
Yeah.
All right, there's a look at the source of the name for the Frenchman, the Hangman.
That is menacing. Look at that.
Yep.
Great camera shot on that. Look, they're coming right in on it.
I'm surprised in a way that the Hangman doesn't in a sense try to use that.
Yeah.
Maybe that'll be a last resort. I don't know.
Maybe the director is trying to tell you something, Dick Grant, about your future.
Frank even said it. He's a good Goomba.
Yeah, good Goomba. Who's that, Frank?
Frankie.
Yeah. Frankie who?
Frank DeVincentis, the man who raises horses and gets great camera shots as our director.
Oh, you're going to get a wonderful close-up of your face for that.
Oh, I don't want that. No more.
No more. That was 20 years ago.
Many years.
Well, back to the match. Yeah. And he's still working where we left him on the left arm. I don't know what Morales is going to do. It's going to be amazing to see if he can use that when he starts to try to fire away.
It's like fighting with only one arm, and I don't know how he can
close up
survive.
Of the face. Look at the pain. It's scar. Like etched in glass. That's a wonderful close up there. Well, we lost it. Look at the face of the Hangman. Look at the concentration there, and the teeth, the mouth open, and he keeps grunting every time he exerts that force.
I understand his mother sends his letters back, address unknown.
Yeah.
No. Uh-oh.
Now, how did he hit him with that left?
I don't know.
It hurt. It did not come easy.
He caught a foot in the face.
Yeah,
there
size 16 in the face.
He's mad. Look, he's getting angry.
Yeah, he's getting worked up now, but the Hangman's still working. Oh.
Another kick to the head, though.
Oh, he kicked his brains in.
Hangman is pacing.
I guess the wrestlers get punch drunk the same as the boxers. Look at the beating there.
Oh.
Another one. It's the third one now.
And he's gaining that momentum. He's right off the ring ropes.
It's a fourth one. I can't believe how Morales takes this punishment. Here comes five.
Hey, look at him. He didn't move.
He didn't budge. He's got to be made of steel. There's no question about it. Number six. The Hangman can't believe it. He can't budge him. The crowd senses the drama that's rising here. Number seven. Oh, he's going crazy now, Morales. Number eight, he can't budge him. Look at what he's doing. He's had it with the left.
Oh, did you hear that?
Oh, I heard it across the whole spectrum. He is the champion, Morales. He is the champion. Oh, look, he's leading him like a mama leading a child. Unloading. Oh, full force with the left. Look. I know his knuckles are red. You can see it from here. Oh, did you hear that? This is it. He wants to finish him. He's got him. Small package. All right. Boy. He took it, and he took it, and he took it. And Puerto Rico fired back. Oh, he's gone for the rope. He's gone after him. Yeah, he's not aware. He's arguing with the referee. Well.
The time, 11 minutes, 2 seconds. Your winner, Pedro.
Dusty holds his hand up in triumph. What was that, 11 minutes? Yeah, 11 minutes, 2 seconds.
The fans, Hangman goes off. Pedro Morales still checking his hand.
Yeah, he hurt his knuckles there.
Yeah, he did.
Okay.
Okay, let's check your screens now because the instant replay will give us the events leading up to the pin. There's a shot to the midsection again. He shoves him into the ring ropes. Here we go. Now, they roll back. And right in position. Dusty Feldbaumer on the scene, and there he goes. All right. Hey, that's beautiful.
I called Pedro over. I think he hurt his knuckle. Let's ask him.
Pedro, did you hurt your hand there?
Yeah. Well, I hit him so hard with my left hook, and I think I can grab a little one of his teeth, you know.
Yeah.
But let me tell you one thing about that man.
Yes.
He's a powerful man. He's way over 300 pounds.
Yes.
And I glad that I'm wrestling with him because I like to wrestle men like him.
Yeah.
Then I can prove, I don't want to sound like I brag, but then I can prove that I can take care of myself.
Yeah, yes, you can. Yeah. I wanted to ask you, how badly did he hurt your left shoulder? He worked on it continually through the match. I was amazed you were able to hit him so hard after
the
he
world, I threw my first punch after he was... How you say that? After he was putting that pressure in the left hook.
Yeah.
When I throw my first left hand, I can feel it, you know. That's why I went down, and I just did a couple of little different things, you know.
Yeah.
But let me tell you one thing.
Yes.
He's a tough and rough, like I say before. I'm glad I'm wrestling with him, and I hope in the coming future I have an opponent like him, because I want to prove not only to the fans here that they always support me, but to the wrestling itself, to the Hangman, to Patera, to Zbyszko, then I can take care of myself.
Right.
Please, I don't want the families to understand me.
Yeah.
I don't want to sound like I brag, but I have a lot of confidence in myself.
Yeah, yeah, chosen a ring.
Yes.
Do you want to be champion again? Are you going back for the championship, Pedro?
Well, everybody want to be champion.
Yeah,
you know that everybody want to be. I was champion, and I would love to.
Well, you showed us plenty tonight. Congratulations,
thank
Pedro.
Thank you. Thank
All
you,
right.
Pedro.
All right, Pedro.
All right, there
Very
you have
good.
It. Pedro Morales said a few words. Beautifully said. The man is a champion all the way.
Ladies and gentlemen, this part of championship wrestling for the Spectrum. It's set for Saturday afternoon, December the 13th, 1:45 p.m. And ladies and gentlemen, here are among the matches already signed by promoter Phil Zacco, as Jose Estrada will meet Steve King. In a tag team match, the team of Angel Marvilla and the fiery Rick McGraw will meet a team making their first appearance in Philadelphia, Lou Albano's Moondogs. And then, ladies and gentlemen, Philadelphia's Rick Stallone will meet the unpredictable Johnny Rodz. And the next match, returning to Philadelphia after a lengthy absence, will be the self-proclaimed king of wrestling, the big cat, Ernie Ladd. And he will meet the former World Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, Pedro Morales.
How about that? Pedro and Ernie Ladd, he wants competition. He's getting it.
Sergeant Slaughter. He will meet Pittsburgh's Dominic DiNucci.
Oh, there's a match, DiNucci. Yeah, he's no pussycat.
Ladies and gentlemen, a double main event. The first, a return match. On one side, the Olympic strongman, Ken Patera. And wrestling fans, he will meet wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino.
Well, they go back to it again. That's
and
quite a card.
The second main event on Saturday afternoon, December 13th. It's a special grudge match as Larry Zbyszko will meet Mr. USA, Tony Atlas.
Well, I told you about that one.
I wouldn't miss that for anything.
Oh.
Wrestling fans, all that action and more is set for the Spectrum Saturday afternoon, December 13th. Special starting time, 1:45. Tickets are now on sale at the box office on the floor, at the Ticketron box offices, and at all Ticketron locations. Another announcement for this evening's card, the 11 p.m. curfew has been lifted.
Well, you know what we said about Tony Atlas? He doesn't get mad. He gets
even.
That is quite a card lined up for Saturday afternoon, with Ken Patera returning against Bruno, and that Ernie Ladd, Pedro Morales, that's got to be the match. I mean, you can see the man was dead serious.
It's going to be a great card, I'll tell you. You fans don't want to miss that at all on Saturday.
December 13th, 1:45 p.m. You've got a good shot of it right there. You heard the crowd roar. The coming of the Samoans, Samoan 1 and Samoan 2, the current tag team champions, as they come into the ring. And now coming from the other side, we've got Rick Martel and Tony Garea.
Well, everybody heard that interview, and this is going to be a test of endurance, a test of stamina.
Indeed so, Cal.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following match is a special tag team attraction. It is set for one fall with a one-hour time limit. It is for the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship. Introducing in the corner to my right, the challengers from Auckland, New Zealand, 243 pounds, Tony Garea. His tag team partner, 235 pounds, from Quebec City, Canada, Rick Martel.
Yeah, the Samoans are trying to battle the words.
This evening, yep. Total combined weight, 613 pounds from the Isle of Samoa. They are the current World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Afa Sika, the Samoans.
I don't know whether we get a shot of that at all, whether we saw it as they came in, but the Samoans, one of the Samoans, is favoring his left hand, and in as much as it's very securely bound with bandages and adhesive tape. I think we just there. But he reached around and undid his belt with his bad hand, so I don't know whether it's a ploy or not. But anyway, one of the Samoans may be wrestling at a disadvantage, considering the fact he has apparently a bad hand. Going back now to our interview at the intermission area, Tony Garea said he and Rick Martel haven't known each other a long time, but they're totally ready for this tonight because the belt maybe will change hands again. Garea's had the belt three times before. Martel never has. But this is going to be interesting tonight, fans, so let's look out. With the Samoans, you never know what's going to happen. As Johnny Rodz is unpredictable, so are the Samoans. And we'll find out just how well Garea and Martel cope with these guys tonight.
Well, the Samoans are trying the intimidation thing. They're doing a Sergeant Slaughter trip. He keeps talking. Yeah. Rick Martel could care less.
Martel is cat quick. Look at him. Did you see that?
Hi, Rake.
That's Tony Garea yells at Dick Worley, the third man in the ring, to watch out. Whoa! Watch out for the eyes. And there's the Samoan crashing to the canvas after heading into the ring corner. The tag made. Dick Worley didn't see it. And there's a knee to the upper arm area of the Samoan.
And a powerful knee it was, too.
All right.
They're alternating back and forth.
Oh, no. Clever.
Like an Adagio team. Look at them. That was full force. Absolute full force. They are not playing.
Tony Garea is really, really very interested in getting that belt back. I'm sure Martel is too, but he's never had it before. Garea really wants it. And tonight could be the night, fans. We don't know.
Well, as Tony said, he's at the peak of his power, of his wrestling prowess.
He really is.
He's in his mid-30s, even less, and it's now or never. And he's had it three times, and he wants it a fourth, and Martel, you know how hungry he is.
Yeah. All right, there's an arm bar and a lock on it by Tony Garea, maintaining that pressure, but he better not get back to the... he knows.
Caught him unawares. He was not even ready.
He gave him a shot, man. Oh. Did he ever? There's a tag, and here comes Martel again.
He nearly tore the arm off.
Watching these guys work out, Garea and Martel, as if they've been working together as a tag team for a long time.
They've got their chops down.
You do.
They got them. A man with a plan. They really got it together. Great coordination.
Oh, comes a body slam, Martel.
Full force. Didn't break it with his feet either. Right back.
Nice takedown by Martel. And another takedown. You've noted that on the back of Martel, there's that extended hand by the Samoan. And I guess Martel's going to work on it.
Oh, that was hard. This is punishing. Again.
Only this time it was Garea did it, leapfrog.
He walked into that one.
He gave a shoulder block, and now the tag, they're wearing him down. You know, he innovated that tonight.
Yeah.
When we did the interview with Garea, you might remember at the intermission fans, Garea said, I think we're going to wear him down.
Yeah, very confident.
That might be the way to get to these guys. They're strong as can be, those Samoans. Oh, he hears sounds nobody hears, fans. Yeah, a little symphony orchestra going off on that head, probably. Look at the agony on that man's face. Good shot. All right, there's Martel coming. Whoa, look at that, look.
What
speed, nice
incredible, grease lightning.
You talk about agility.
Yeah, grease lightning.
You talk about agility. You saw Martel lightning quick. There's a tag, and here comes Garea.
All right.
Oh! These guys are chopping the Samoans to pieces tonight, and just the way he predicted.
Yep. They are two very good-looking men, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure the ladies out there are losing it just looking at them. Martel's an incredible-looking guy. They're a little signal there. They're... Oh, look at the force of that block. Is he? He walked into that.
Yes, he did. What a body slam and a kick. All right. Nicely done by Tony Garea. And he grabs the other Samoan who just came into the ring after the tag. He goes down. Oh.
They are breaking arms tonight.
Oh, they are really doing it tonight, fans.
You wouldn't believe there was the weight difference that you see.
Yeah. And a kick out. Oh, the drop kick. Oh, another arm drag, and down he goes. I'll tell you.
Martel is amazing.
Martel,
he really is.
You think he's been wrestling about 20 years.
Oh. I'm sure the high school and college wrestlers or elementary school wrestlers out there are in absolute awe of this man.
These guys are just, as we said many times over, incredible. The moves are not to be believed.
I wonder what the wrestling coaches think of this performance.
Well, it ain't fancy, but it's effective.
Yeah.
Shoulder block.
See him drive that shoulder in him? Again?
Do they play football as we do?
Oh, they play rugby, rugby.
Oh, he goes outside the ring. Garea took off like a 727. Referee Dick Worley is distracted as the other Samoan gives a shot to the face.
See, Martel's still young. He doesn't know. He better stay in a corner. Oh,
he's going to slam him down. Rick Martel's gone after him.
Stand for it.
He's going to try to help.
Look at that close-up. Look at that face. Only a mother could love it.
Martel. Yeah. Martel warning away the Samoan. He said, you better back off, man.
Get slammed on that concrete that way.
Oh, that's smart.
Concrete does not give, Dick Graham.
No?
Not at all. Oh.
Right on the arm.
Yeah, the left
right
shoulder,
on the shoulder.
Yeah, shoulder, yeah. The great equalizer. Oh, that is painful. That's one thing they do is that claw.
Look at the face. Look at the face on. Look at it. He's gone.
Yeah, he's out there.
That Samoan is someplace else.
Look at those eyes. They're up in his forehead and bigger than half dollars.
There's a little reminder, fans, if you blinked your eyes a couple of times, following Spectrum Wrestling tonight, Rocky II, our big feature film. I'll tell you, you see it all on PRISM.
Now, that's painful. That hold is painful, the way they apply it.
Well, we said earlier they worked on that, so there's the tag, and here we go again.
Well, they're working on his left shoulder.
I don't know which one this is, Hoffa or Sika, but whichever one, he's doing the job all over again that his brother did a few minutes ago. Well, we're past the 11 o'clock curfew time, so obviously that's been waived.
Yeah, that was waived. What was a long card tonight? Nine bouts?
Yeah.
The fans, nobody can complain they didn't get their money's worth. What a show. Nothing but action.
Oh, there's a count of two.
Yeah.
And there's the Samoan applying more pressure to the upper shoulder area of Garea.
Yeah, he's on the deltoid muscle, and that hurts. Look at the pressure on it.
All right.
Tony
there's
Garea.
Martel clapping his hands, trying to get the fans incited, trying to get them to... Yeah, and I think they're working. It's working. Garea trying to get on both feet again so he can get it going, although the pain seems to be unbearable.
Yeah. Yeah, Tony's... He's going to reverse. What a shot with the elbow.
Here's the tag made again. Boy, they're going crazy tonight. The fans are trying to get Garea to get it together. They're just trying to transfer their strength to him. He's in a bad spot right now, man.
They are working that shoulder over.
They are.
That's the fourth match that's been the case.
I think if anything happens here, you see the key to this might be the fact that Martel and Garea have not been interchanging here as they had over the last 4 or 5 minutes. And now Garea is getting the getting his lumps. He's
well,
trying to force.
Look at him. It's like a football lineman in spring training. He didn't see it. Dick Worley didn't see
it. He didn't see the tag.
Martel should just go back and leave it alone. They're killing him there in the corner. Look at his brutal attack. Can you imagine two gorillas like that smacking you at the same time from one side to the other?
I try not to think
about
it.
That's a nightmare. You wake up in the middle of the night screaming. The Samoans
really
are powerful.
Bad shape.
Yeah.
This is a Pier 6 brawl tonight, man.
Well, we predicted it. Oh, there's that claw. Right on the deltoid. Oh, the agony. Look at it. Look at a close-up on his face.
Right. Martel moved around the other side of the ring post so he can be in a position should Garea be able to get to him and make that tag.
Yeah, Martel's got to learn. He's still young and a hothead. And learn that you can't argue with the referee once he's made a decision. And you just put your partner into jeopardy by arguing with the referee and distracting him from what's going on. Tony's yelling with the pain, yelling. That's incredible pain. Right on the deltoid muscle.
Right.
He broke it.
He broke it. Knocked him down. He better make that tag.
He's got him. Not quite. Not quite. Missed it by half a count.
Thought he had it for a second.
That was like 2.5. He could have gone to Martel, but he thought he could finish that first fall.
I think he wanted to pay the Samoan back.
He's got the rope. He's got him. Worley doesn't see the rope. And he's... Worley doesn't know about the rope yet. Does he see
he's
it yet? Yeah,
it.
Now he sees it.
He finally saw it.
Finally saw it. Oh, is he hot, Worley, about that? Is he hot? Yeah, you better hold that rope. Well, he's taken quite a beating. He's been there a long time.
Garea still wants to get at him, though. Right back again. He said, oh, no.
Yeah. Oh, no. Oh, no.
He's got to get to Martel here shortly for that tag.
He's got to get to him. It's frustrating. Look, he doesn't know what to do. Oh, the pain is unbearable. I can hardly look at this. Can you, Dick Graham?
No.
Look, they're cheerleading the crowd. The crowd just urging him on.
He better get to Martel.
Oh, no, he's gone for the can.
He won't do it.
Yeah. Oh. They're both out now. I can't believe the length of time that Garea's been in that ring.
Well, now, the Samoan seems to be ready. He can make the tag. He did.
All right.
Martel has gone crazy. He's taking them both on.
Well, he was bottled up for so long. Oh, brutal.
He's a one-man band. Look at him.
Here it comes. It's going to be Bonzo Gonzo.
Oh!
Look at that double drop kick. Unbelievable. What
we
action.
May be seeing some history made here tonight, fans. Look at.
Here it comes. Bonzo Gonzo. Oh, I don't believe it.
Samoa's got it.
The Samoan thinks that he counted Garea out.
Yeah.
But it wasn't Garea.
What do we have?
I don't know. Who was counted out?
Listen, the place is coming apart.
I don't believe this. They both think they won. He's got Gary Capetta. What's going on? Look at Gary. Boy, Gary and Michael are all shook up. Well, wait a minute.
All right.
Dick Worley is going to tell us all. All right. He's building the suspense. Okay. We're going to find out because we don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time of the match, 14 minutes, 29 seconds. The winners and new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Rick Martel and Tony Garea.
The Samoans can't believe it. They can't believe it. They were sure that he was going out. They can't believe it. How could this be? They heard the count. Oh. They can't believe it.
Cannot understand it. You told us. Come here.
What did I tell you?
Hey!
What did I tell you?
All right.
Yeah, you told us you would win, Tony. You told us. Congratulations. What?
Look at this. The strategy paid off.
Yeah, it finally paid off.
Way to go, Rick Martel.
Yeah, I would say
fantastic.
This is the greatest moment of my life.
Yes.
And I thank Tony because he's been a true partner.
You can watch it. Here, watch it. Here it is on a monitor.
Oh, look. He got me the son of a gun.
Yeah.
Look at that. Out like a...
Yeah, he knocked you cold, didn't he?
Yes.
I saw him bend out. I was the legal man in there.
Great,
so.
Yeah.
I was a legal man, so I had to go for the pin right there.
We did it, Danny. There we go.
Yeah.
Oh, man, it was out of it. I wish I had seen.
All right.
Great stuff, Rick.
You saw it.
You guys call it tonight. You call it.
I would like to say thank you to the people because they've been a great support, and if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here right now with the belts. Thank you, everybody.
We love you.
We love you.
They love you, Rick Martel. They love you.
Thank you.
Wait a minute.
I said we'd do it. We've done it. I knew that.
Okay, Tony.
They call it tonight.
Fantastic.
We might as well just stand up, Cal.
Boy, what excitement.
Dad!
Rick Martel is out of his mind. That young kid.
Crazy city tonight. Crazy city.
Unbelievable. Boy, the crowd got a show. Here, let's get over here. My chair is broken. Everything went. Okay. All right, Dick Graham.
All right.
Okay.
Now I think I can hear what's going on. Yeah.
Well, what do you think?
All right.
Okay.
Well, that's about...
Yeah. Yeah, what would you say there, Dick?
That's about it tonight, fans. I don't know. I think the action speaks for itself tonight. We've seen it all tonight, fans. We've seen the tag team belts change hands from the Samoans to Rick Martel. Have Tony Garea, as Garea called it, he said it could happen. That's when we did the interview at the intermission time.
Right.
We saw it all happen tonight. Backlund, of course, retains his belt. And it's all going to start all over again on Saturday, December 13th, fans, at 1:45. Be here.
Yeah, okay. Dick Graham.
Kal Rudman, Dick Graham saying bye-bye. Good night, fans.
Bye.
In the movie.